I'm Christine Granger. My first year of life, it was discovered that I had a birth defect, as they called it, and that I had a major bone in my leg missing. So I grew up wearing a leg brace, and till the time I was 13, I wore the brace consistently, and then I had surgery at the age of 13. As I got older, I didn't need the brace as much. I'd had surgery where they lengthened my leg, and I had another surgery where they fused my ankle, and it made it just so much easier for me to walk, and I didn't have to wear the brace. As I arrived in my 30s with problems with my leg, I arrived at Temple, and I was saved. Through the years at Temple, I've had a lot of prayer, a lot of help for different things. Things like moving and having somebody to come and put my bed together. Always, always, always somebody stepped up to help me. None of my family were saved, but Temple was very appealing to them. The fact that they wanted to help me, the fact that they did help me. My mom, she came a few times to church, but she didn't really want to come regularly. My dad just had nothing to do with church whatsoever. However, before they both died, they were saved. And I had a younger brother that died of cancer, and it was Pastor Gary who at the time went to visit him in the hospital and led him to the Lord. I came into the church not loving my family very much at all. Loved them to pieces before they all died. I did whatever I could for my family because the Lord gave me a love for them. So anyways, I continued on with problems with my leg, but they got worse in my 40s. So one day I was out and I had a sharp pain in my foot, and I sat down because I thought it was the shoes I was wearing. I rubbed my foot and it seemed okay. By the time I got home, my foot was very, very swollen and I couldn't walk on my foot by then. When I finally got to see the doctors in Toronto, and what they told me was that the fusion they did on my ankle when I was 18 had broken. It was the same as walking on a broken bone. At that time, they didn't feel that I should go unaided, told to use a cane, which I did, but they put me back in a brace. To raise the funds to get this brace, I just get partway there and something else happens and I have to dig into my savings. In September, there was a prayer retreat, and I've never been to one. I've never had the opportunity to be here for one. So I did go to this one and they asked for prayer requests. So they got to me and asked me if I had any requests, and I shared two or three with them. Mary invited me to come out to the Bible study a few weeks back, and I can't see. I don't go to them because I can't see right now, as I'm waiting to have cataract surgery. So I would have said no, except it was Mary asking. So I went, not being able to read anything, and I sat and I listened during the study. And at the end, Mary stood up and she said, "I bet you're wondering now why we asked you to come." And I said, "Well, yeah." And she said, "Well, do you remember at the prayer retreat you had a prayer request?" So she mentioned about the brace. And I actually had forgot that I had used that as a prayer request. But at $1,000, I didn't think it was going to happen at any time soon. The ladies had decided that they wanted to help me to get this brace. So from September on, they were collecting money to help pay for this brace. They gave me an envelope with over $1,000 in it. I thank them not for what they did for me, but for listening to God and for taking God's leading in this matter. And they loved me enough that they actually raised what I needed. I just haven't been used to this type of treatment for a long time. I haven't needed much. So ladies, I don't think you'll ever know exactly what you did. It wasn't just raising money for me, but you really brought God back into my life in a very big way through your love and through your willingness to listen to God. You've done quite the number on me, as well as a lot of people who know me that I've been able to share the story with. So all I can say now is thank you from the bottom of my heart. I really can't think of any more words that I need to say other than thank you, but it's meant in a big way.